Pat Farbaugh here with head coach Chris Valerio. Chris, two hard-fought, tight losses against nationally ranked, fully funded FCS programs on the road. How's the team's morale right now going into the Columbia game?
We're hurting a little bit, but you know, we're a little beat up. But guys are getting lots of treatment, and we got lots of ice bags right now. But you know, guys are starting to respond. We have another one today to get ready for Columbia, and you know, we're looking forward to getting this thing back on track and getting this thing together and getting on the bus and going up to Columbia and try to have a victory.
Entering the preseason, one of the biggest question marks in terms of positions was wide receiver. You lost Terrell Smith, you lost Anthony Abide, Dan Adams. They are all gone and graduated. We've seen some younger guys step up. Cam Lewis, two touchdowns, Junior Ajayi, had a half dozen catches at Towson, a solid game at Montana. Your thoughts on that position through the two games so far?
We're starting to get some production out of that area, and I think that we haven't even touched it yet. I think that these guys, as they develop and get more comfortable in the system, I think it could be a great asset for us. It could be a weapon. So we're looking just to keep developing and trying to make positive plays.
The performance of Bagley, almost 100 yards again at Towson. He ran for 95 and 96 yards at Montana and Towson, respectively. He seems to have hit the ground running two games into the season.
Yeah, Marcus is running hard for us. You know, we still got to iron some things out with him to get him more comfortable in the system, but he's taken that lead role on as the lead back, and I think as he matures, we're going to see even better things out of Marcus throughout the year.
An opponent we've never seen before in school history, Columbia, first ever game against an Ivy League school as well. Interestingly, we have two games in, Columbia's first game of the season. They've been a team that has struggled. They haven't had a winning season in a decade. However, they 2-8 last year. They thumped Wagner 26-3, and six of their eight losses were by 10 points or less. So what are the biggest concerns that you have after looking at tape of the Lions?
They have a great, first and foremost, they have a great staff. You know, their head coach formed a great staff. They got a lot of NFL experience. You know, next is they were ranked third in the country defensively. They don't make a lot of mistakes. They're gap sound, fundamentally sound. They're a good team, and they have a great quarterback on the offensive side of the ball. He can make you pay. He can run. He can scramble. They bring a backup in that does a little more of the running. But you know, they have a great field general in there that I think that he's doing a great job. And they have a great running back. They're cohesive up front. So we have our work cut out for us, and it's going to be a battle, and it's just going to be one of these games. It's going to come down to the last 2 minutes of the game.
Chris, good luck on Saturday.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Pat Farbaugh with sophomore wide receiver Cam Lewis. Cam, first off, congratulations.
Thank
on
you.
The first collegiate touchdown
you.
Of your career.
Thank
Can you,
you
describe them to us? You had two TDs, three catches, two of them for scores against Towson. Can you describe the two pass plays that went for six?
My first touchdown was a coverage breakdown, and we game planned it all week. We practiced it, repped it. So we figured whenever they were in the right coverage for us to run that play, we would run it, and we scored a touchdown on it. That was my first touchdown. And then my second touchdown, it was just our defense got a turnover, and there was a 50-50 ball, and they trusted me to make the play, and I made the catch and scored.
You're a sophomore, but really a leader on this receiving core. A number of receivers have graduated from last year. Are you excited about that responsibility to serve as a leader, even though it's only your second year?
Yeah, I'm coming from Terrell and Daniel Adams being older guys last year. They showed me a lot. I learned from them, watched them play, got in when I got my opportunities, and just learned. And now I'm trying to help other receivers that haven't played that much, or the younger guys, or even the older guys that are older than me. I'm just trying to fill in that role that they left last year.
And then I want to go back to your high school career. Your senior year at Edison High School out in Fresno, California, Edison won a Division I Valley Championship for the first time in 39 years, almost four decades, went 12-1.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me how exciting that was for the program. St. Francis is trying to do something similar after a long dry spell, capture a title. What was that like as a senior helping lead Fresno to that championship?
It's all about finishing. We were contending every year, and we'd get close, but we'd never finish. And our senior year, we had a good group of guys, played together as a team, came together, didn't really give up, practiced hard every day, and we just finished the season 12-1, ended up winning the Valley Championship, and I feel St. Francis the same opportunity. We just need to finish, and we'll be a good team, great team.
Well, good luck this weekend against Columbia.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thanks. Pat Farber with senior linebacker Solomon Laiano from Kapolei, Hawaii. Second on the team in tackles with 15, three of those for losses. He's second on the team in tackles a year ago with 63 and has gotten off to a good start at a 31-yard fumble return out at Montana. A solid game at Towson. Solomon, you're one of the leaders of this linebacking core. How would you rate the progress of some of the team's younger linebackers? How are you? Are you as a leader pleased with their progress?
I am. These young guys have picked up our game plan quick. You know, I remember my freshman year, it was tough for me to pick up the game plan for the upcoming games, but these guys have adjusted well. I'm very proud of them, but they can always get better. You know, we have a mission ahead of us, and for me, I'll just continue to keep leading them and keep pushing them to be their best, you know. And I'm very proud of where they're at and what they've done these past 2 weeks.
You had 9 tackles and 2 sacks a year ago in the finale at Duquesne, and that was, in essence, the Northeast Conference championship game. How much did that loss motivate you over the summer through preseason camp, a chance to get back to where you're playing for a conference title?
That game, actually, it stings a lot. It stings a lot because, you know, that team last year, we worked very hard to get where we're at. And over the summer and during the off-season training, I believe that game really brought our team together as one, because I feel that, you know, that bond that a team should have, I think we have it now. And we are motivated, and we're taking one game at a time, and I believe that we have the team to do it. You know, these 2 games, it has been a good learning experience, and one thing we got to do and finish is really finish the game and finish our opponent. You know, we start off well, and our defense and offense both played well. We just got to come together as a team at the end and finish our games. And that game, that Duquesne game, it tingles, you know, because I know our boys are ready for that game when it's coming up.
Congrats and good
luck
this
weekend. Thank you. God bless.